Welcome back to the channel, everyone. We're going to be doing another comparison today. This is going to be a camera comparison this time around, and we're going to be looking at the Galaxy S10 and comparing it to the Galaxy S20 in terms of the camera. Now, I tried my best to do everything to compare everything I could, and this is probably the best one I could have probably came down to, and it's still not perfect, but whatever. Now, I'm going to talk about the hardware for a second. The Samsung Galaxy S10 has, first of all, they both have triple camera setups. The Samsung Galaxy S10 has a 12-megapixel wide-angle lens, 12-megapixel telephoto lens, and then a 16-megapixel ultra-wide sensor, where the Samsung Galaxy S20 has a 12-megapixel wide-angle lens, 64-megapixel telephoto lens, and then a 12-megapixel ultra-wide sensor. And in terms of the core and everything, they're both almost the same. When I was taking photos and everything, you know, I noticed, yeah, there were some cool things here and there between them both, but I kind of saw that for sure there were some cool differences, and I thought I saw some better ones over the, you know, the camera viewfinder. But after the end of it, I noticed they were, you know, about the same when I looked at them in the photos. So that pretty much covers it up in the hardware. The Samsung Galaxy S20 has that really cool feature of being able to shoot 8K videos, which is seriously really awesome. Not a lot of phones have that capability, but on the Samsung Galaxy S20, we have that. So that pretty much covers it up on the outside and the body. Let's go ahead and look at the photos. So I'll go ahead and pull up my screen right now. And as you can see, I have two images on the left and right. The Samsung Galaxy S10 photos will always be on the left. The Samsung Galaxy S20 photos will always be on the right. So now that we have that awkwardness out of the way, looking at the first photo, you can already kind of see some few differences. Now, I try my best to take them at the exact same locations and everything every single time. These were taken at the exact same moments in the exact same time, literally like 1 second apart from each other. So you can already see kind of that the S10, I think, photo looks a little bit better. If you kind of look at the side right here, if you look at like the little darkness that I left, you can see that this one looks a little bit lighter. The Samsung Galaxy S20s looks a little bit darker. However, when you kind of get to this area of the curtain, you can kind of see that it looks a little bit more detailed and, in my opinion, a little bit better on the Samsung Galaxy S20 over the Samsung Galaxy S10. And this isn't the end-all be-all, but that is one thing that I immediately saw right out the gate. If I look to the edge, you can kind of see a little bit of difference. So again, the Samsung Galaxy S20 is on the right, the Samsung Galaxy S10 is on the left, and from the first photo, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I think the S10 looked a little bit better in this case. Now this next photo is the one of the grass, and you know you already had to do this one on them. As you can see, the Samsung Galaxy S10 photo on the left, from the first glance of like up top, they look almost identically the same. I think we already kind of know that, but when you zoom in, this is when you start to see some of the key differences. So if I zoom in, let's say to like this piece of grass right here, and on this piece of grass right here on the S10, they both look almost the same in terms of the graininess. The S20 kind of looks a little bit more grainy, to be honest, but they look almost the same if I'm being honest. Now if I go to like up top and I kind of look at each one, you can kind of see that they're almost the same graininess. But actually, if I'm being honest, the Samsung Galaxy S20 photo looks a little bit less grainy up here. If you look at like these leaves right here and these ones, you can see they look a lot more smooth. But on the Samsung Galaxy S10, you start to see that it's a lot more grainy actually. And this is something that I saw in my last comparison too. So if you're comparing both cameras, you're going to see a lot less noise on the Samsung Galaxy S20 photo versus the Samsung Galaxy S10. And like I said, from the bird's eye view, you're not going to notice that big of a difference. But when you start zooming in, that's when you start seeing some of that noise, especially when it's on a different background. And even on here, look how much more noise is on these photos and on here versus the Samsung Galaxy S20. Now looking at this next photo, it's the camera lens, and if you guys don't know, I usually just let the cameras just autofocus on themselves. I don't tap to focus or anything like that to make it as accurate as possible. And even on this photo, it actually looks a little bit more weirder on the Samsung Galaxy S20. This has a lot to do with the focus point. The Samsung Galaxy S20's photo was focusing on a different point other than the middle of the lens where the Samsung Galaxy S10's was. But even at that point, you can see that the charger in the back, the little charging port, look how much more blurred out it is on the S20. Even though the Galaxy S20 was focusing on a different point, you can see that it was able to blur the background a little bit better on the Samsung Galaxy S20 versus the Samsung Galaxy S10. And even if I look at a little edge like this, this little edge point right here, you can see that this part was more blurred out, which is what you want. You want the backgrounds to be more blurred out than, you know, the focus point, because this, you don't want to be able to see it as much because you want that thing in the center in focus. You want that to be in focus and not necessarily the background. So even though the S20's photo was focusing on a different point, it did do a better job overall at blurring out that background, which is really, really nice. And this next photo was taken outside of pretty much the same exact leaves, and I try to make them focus. Again, I don't tap to focus, but I try to go back and forth and try to see if they're gonna focus. And these both focus at the same exact points every single time. And you can see that the S10 was able to focus on this part of the leaf right here. The S20 though was able to focus on this part of the leaf while still kind of keeping this leaf in focus too. And even if we just look at this first leaf, I mean, look at this one and look at the one in the S20. You're getting much more information on the S20's leaf than on this one, and they're the exact same leaf too. It's not like they're different leaves, they kind of look like it though. But you can see on the S20 we're able to get much more detail. And if I zoom into the tip of this one, if I zoom into the tip of this one, look how much more information and just how much better it looks on the S20 versus the S10. Now you could say that there's a little bit less noise around the photo. That is actually a very interesting point, and I have no way to defend that. However, if we look at this leaf right here, you're kind of able to see some bigger differences. And again, I think, I don't know, this one might look a little bit more focused here. This one looks a little bit less out of focus. But if I go and zoom into some other parts right here, this actually might be a little bit funny. You're still able to see that overall the Samsung Galaxy S20 has a little bit more grain on the photos. Again, if you look at the edge, it kind of seems like it's kind of noisy around here. The S20 is a little bit better, so that's something that's really, really you have to consider. But overall, both phones did a really good job at both photos. The autofocus is one thing to consider though. And this is another one of those leaves, and it's the same exact leaf that looks like that Groot guy from Guardians of the Galaxy. If I zoom in, again, all photos are going to look the same if you're from the back end, like if you're looking at it from a really bird's eye view. But once you zoom in, you get to start seeing some big differences. And if I zoom into the face that's within the leaves, look how much more detail and how much more in focus the leaves are on the S20 versus the S10. You kind of see that's a little bit more out of focus. It doesn't look as sharp. And even when at this leaf, you can definitely see it with this one. It looks like a little bit blurry on the Samsung Galaxy S10. On the Samsung Galaxy S20, it looks a little bit more in focus, which is something that you really, really want. So in this photo, I will definitely give the edge to the Samsung Galaxy S20 for sure. The S10 did a pretty decent job, but the S20 definitely won here. Now this next photo, I kind of wanted to see how both phones interpreted this brown color. In all honesty, I think the S10 did a better job of showing it true to life, but I'm sure some people might like it this way on the Samsung Galaxy S20. So it's really weird how one does kind of over-filtering and the other one doesn't. And this was all non-filtered, I didn't filter these things. Even this video isn't color graded or anything like that. This photo is completely raw as it was taken on the Samsung Galaxy S20 and S10 on stock settings. And it's weird how both phones can interpret this brown color completely different on both phones. So I'm not really sure which one's the winner here, but again, the S20 probably did it more accurately to life than the Samsung Galaxy S20 did, and I meant the Samsung Galaxy S10 did it better than the Samsung Galaxy S20. So now this next photo I took of just this light thing, and even when you're looking at direct sunlight or direct light in general, look how much better the Samsung Galaxy S20 photo is over the Samsung Galaxy S10. And I actually didn't even do ultra wide, and I don't think I did ultra wide. I might have done it, I don't really remember. But if you look at both, I mean, look how much better the Samsung Galaxy S20 photo is. I can zoom into this light itself. Hopefully, you guys don't get blinded. If I zoom into the light at the bottom of this, they both almost look exactly the same. If I zoom out, you can definitely see, even without zooming in, the photo on the S20 looks so much better than on the Samsung Galaxy S10. And this is the next photo, pretty much right next to it. And again, you don't really see too many differences. I kind of think that the S10 photo looks a little bit better here. If you look at the exact droplets, honestly, I think the S10 did a better job, which is kind of funny. So they go back and forth quite a bit. Now this next photo is of portrait mode on both devices, and you get to see how both phones do live focus mode. And one thing is when you look at them side by side, I think the S20s looks a little bit sharper, but the favorite thing I like doing is zooming into the face of this thing to creep you guys out, but more so to look at the grains of ears and just to look at the hairs that are coming off. So if I look at the corner of this thing and I zoom in, you'll probably be able to see that there's going to be more noise on the S10 photo than on the Samsung Galaxy S20 photo. And again, that's 100% the truth. Look how much darker the background is here and how much more, less grainy it is here versus on the Samsung Galaxy S10. So that's a pretty big thing to consider right there. Now this next photo, it might seem like a really annoying, weird thing, but I wanted to demonstrate the telephoto lens on both phones. So this is the furthest they both go. So the S10, this is how far it goes, the 10x zoom. The Samsung Galaxy S20 is able to do 30x zoom. And if you look at the little stick right here, this is how far the Samsung Galaxy S20 is able to zoom in further than on the S10. So you're able to see the stick. Now obviously it's super blurry, nobody's really going to like it. If you zoom in here, you can kind of see that you can do that capability on the Samsung Galaxy S20 where you don't have that on the S10, and you still have that same 10x zoom on the S20 as well. It's not like it's taken away. So that's a pretty big deal right there. Now this next photo is the one I usually do. I didn't really see that big of a difference between this one, but for some reason, sometimes the Samsung Galaxy S10 is able to do a better focusing point at exactly where I want to focus at versus the S20. You see, I kind of wanted to focus in this area a little bit, get a lot of that info, but on the S20, you can see it didn't focus there. It focused like right, even, I don't even know where it was focusing at. Maybe like right here or something like that. So the focus points I think are better on the S10 than on the S20 sometimes. Now I took this photo of the trees, and again, you know, I like seeing how both phones interpret the coloring outside. It's probably more true to life on the S10 on this time. And you can see if I zoom in, you know, there's not going to be that much graininess going around. It's actually kind of a freaky photo a little bit. If I zoom into the trees, you're not going to notice that big of a difference anyway, but both phones did a pretty good job. I think I like the S10's photo though more a little bit. You know, they're both almost the same, but I think I like the S10. And I might actually drop this for a song cover. This actually looks pretty nice. I didn't even realize that. Now this is another photo. Yeah, this isn't even that good a one. You guys aren't even going to notice that much information about it, but they look almost the same. This one looks a little bit warmer here. The S10 looks pretty much the same, a little bit more creamy here. Now I'll go ahead and show you guys the videos that I took on both phones, and they both look pretty good. They both look almost exactly the same. Sometimes I kind of did some weird things here and there, and when I'm filming them from the viewfinder again, I don't really notice that big of a difference, but ultimately they look almost the same. But just know that these are both at 1080p. I didn't film it at 4K or anything because all these videos were rendered down at 1080p, so there's no point in filming any more than that. But what I can tell you is that even if the video quality, they were about this, like I didn't notice one being way better than the other one. There were some smooth shots on the S20 that I liked, where the I think the OIS is a little bit better on the S20. But what I can tell you about both cameras is that the S10 really surprised me. The S20, for some reason, I had this like preconceived notion that it was going to be like the best camera in the world and it was going to be crazy and this and that. And it really is. It's a very good camera. But from what I've been testing from even against the iPhone 11 yesterday and the S20 today, the main advantages are that higher telephoto lens and the megapixel count with the ability to shoot 8K videos. Other than that, and that 30x zoom, I guess, but other than that, there's really not that many advantages or that much, you know, in terms of quality that kind of make me side for the S20 over the S10 in this example. I think the S20 is a great camera. I think it's probably one of the better cameras out, but the S10 is still also a very good camera. When I compare the quality here, there wasn't really that big of a difference between them, if I'm being honest. So that really pretty much covers it up there. If you guys have any questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. If you want to purchase the S10 or S20, links will be down in the description. You can get them from there and help support the channel at the same time. But that is pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section as well. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. All those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.